John, and today we're going to talk about the Ride1Up e-bike. I'm not a professional reviewer, so anyways, I picked up this, I ordered this on Sunday. It arrived on a Wednesday, and it took about a half hour to put together. It was $1,000. I opted for the, I did actually add some upgrades. I added the fenders and the rack, which brought the price up $100. And I also got an upgraded LCD controller, and that was $70 or so. And I added this $20 lock. It has a cable too. I got it velcroed right now to the rack. But I don't have a lot of accessories for this because I just got it. Anyways, I've had it for a couple days and it has been a blast. I can't believe how well engineered and what a great value it is. So anyways, one of my dreams has always been to ride my bike to Multnomah Village. I live in a very hilly part of southwestern Portland, Oregon. And there's a cool like little town, like little village about 2 or 3 miles away. But I've never been able to get to it. I mean, I've ridden my bike to it once and I ended up pushing it back. So we're gonna try to ride down there. Riding down will be an issue. It's gonna be coming back. It's gonna be interesting. A lot of hills. So, oh, nice kickstand. Turned on the electricity. Okay. Put up to 6, I think that'll do it. And let's see what we got here. Hattie. So. Not too bad. So. We're off. I noticed sometimes the kickstand comes out of alignment. So on the right hand stroke, left foot stroke, it knocks the kickstand. Anyways, just knocked it back into place. Not a big deal. Okay, this has got 7 gears. This is a hill I normally have to struggle with. I can't tell you how awesome it is to just be blazing up it. I am pedaling, still getting exercise. There's a lot of gravel over here, so I can just go slow. Downshift. Gear, so I'm having trouble with this thumb lever. I'm not sure if it's supposed to pop back into place like that. I kind of have to manually do it. But it's not a big deal. I'll figure out how to adjust it. Okay. This bike uses a cadence sensor, so he can tell you if you're pedaling, but not how hard you're pedaling. And this is my first e-bike, so I don't know any better. I do have a a juiced CCX coming in October. It is October. So this bike will most likely be given to the family. Probably my wife or my oldest daughter. But for now, it's mine. And as you can see, I'm adjusting. Should have downshifted. I need throttle. And here's another case. The brakes are a little bit squeaky. They weren't. That's a new thing today. Okay. Here's a hill. And I'm gonna need a little throttle help. Awesome. End of road, huh? Okay, that's not what I expected. Oh wait, did the trail go on? Yeah. Okay. So pedal assist right now is set up for 9 levels, actually 10, 0, 3, 9. But I got into the BIOS of this thing, and there's all kinds of settings you can do. I don't know if that goes through. Does the trail go through? Yeah. My friend Andrew used to live down this road, Andy McCabe. I'm not trying to speed this out. I'm just having a leisurely ride. I think there's a school down here. Smith Elementary. Soccer games today. Okay, I don't really know where I'm at, but I'm going to try to make my way down to Garden Home Road. Yeah. on the Metro Bike there website, it said that Garden Hub Road is a good, like a biking assist road, like not a dedicated bike path, but a bike friendly path. But I'm gonna say that's a lie. That is a total lie. So, we're doing 28 miles an hour. I'm gonna see a car behind me. So, okay, clear, no cars on the back side. Okay, I'm not holding anyone up. I wish that would come back. Okay. Throttle to get you up to speed. It's awesome. Okay, so the speed limit on this bridge is 20 miles an hour. So that cat is definitely not doing 20. I'm doing 22 and he's still passing. Okay, this is Multnomah Village. Thank you. and this is my destination. Looking for a place to lock up this bike. Front suspension. I don't know if it's air or spring. It's nice though. It works. This place, this tea shop that I like, is in the in Multnomah Village here. Or, sorry, in this place, area called the French Quarter. And I'm gonna stop.